10 years ago, I started Speedy Tuesday. And I could not have imagined that today there would be over 300,000 posts on Instagram with the hashtag Speedy Tuesday. What I also could not have imagined is that we would have done 2 Speedmaster watches together with Fratello and Omega. The Speedy Tuesday 1, the tribute to Alaska 3, and the Speedy Tuesday 2, Ultraman. And ever since, Omega introduces a new Speedmaster on every first Tuesday of the new year. And today I'm super excited because in my hands I have the Speedmaster Caliber 321 in Canopus Gold. Besides 10 years of Speedy Tuesday, this year marks the 65th anniversary of the Speedmaster. In 1957, the Speedmaster was introduced to the world, together with the Railmaster and the Seamaster 300. But today it's about the Speedmaster. And the first Speedmaster was the CK2915, fetching world record prices on auctions. It was only in production for 2 years. And this year, Omega introduces a reproduction of that very first Speedmaster, but in 18-karat Canopus Gold. The dial of this Speedmaster Caliber 321 in Canopus Gold is made of onyx. So Omega used multiple layers of the dial. The first layer is like a normal brass layer that they gave a black coating. Then they put on top 3 subdials in onyx and a top layer in onyx as well. That creates this little 0.05 millimeter step on the side, which is exactly the same number as the step of the original CK2915. The numerals are made of 18 karat white gold. What we also see is the applied logo is made of 18 karat white gold, as well as the hands. It's not Canopus Gold, because in Canopus Gold is also, for example, platinum, which is very difficult to polish. So what they did is they used 18 karat white gold, and then they used like a PVD treatment of Canopus Gold to get the same color as the rest of the watch. Very interesting thing about this watch is the white gold bezel. Of course, the first Speedmaster CK2915 had a steel bezel. This one comes with a Canopus white gold bezel. Instead of using black lacquer, Omega decided to use Grand Feu technique. It's a technique done by artisans in Switzerland. It's like enamel and it has 3 layers. So it went into the oven 3 times, heated up to over 900 degrees Celsius, and it has this glossy finish done with some icing kind of process to get rid of the matte look when it comes out of the oven. It's beautifully done, and it also shows, together with the dial and the movement, that this watch is like Haute Horlogerie by Omega. The dimensions of this watch are exactly the same as the first Speedmaster Broad Arrow. The step in the dial has exactly the same height as the original dial, but also the case, it measures the same 38.6 millimeters in diameter. It's 13.92 millimeters in height, and the lug-to-lug is 48 millimeters. The interesting thing is that the original Speedmaster used a Hasselite crystal, so plexi crystal. This one uses a sapphire crystal, and still it has the same height. Also, the crown and pushers are exactly the same as the original one. Interesting is that this crown has the Mercedes star or Neyat logo on the crown inside the Omega logo. So inside is Caliber 321. The Caliber 321 inside this watch is very similar to the original Caliber 321. The difference is that this one has a Setna gold plating for the finishing, and the original one had a copper colored finishing. Special about this Caliber 321 movement, of course, is that it was the only movement used on the moon by Omega. It's a column wheel chronograph. It has a ticking speed of 18,000 beats per hour and a power reserve of 44 hours. Before looking at the movement, if we turn this watch around, what we will see is something very special. And there's a patent by Omega there as well. If you look carefully at the crystal, you will see that the hippocampus, or seahorse, has been laser engraved in the sapphire crystal. But what's more, the eye of the hippocampus is in fact a set sapphire stone inside the sapphire crystal. Last but not least, there's the bracelet. This bracelet is identical to the bracelet used on the Speedmaster Caliber 321 in stainless steel. It tapers from 19 millimeters between the lugs to 15 millimeters at the clasp and is 2.6 millimeters thick. The difference is that it has an easy adjustment system inside the clasp in order to extend it during hot summer days where your wrist will expand a little bit. You can extend the bracelet by 2.3 millimeters. Personally, I really like this watch. It's all about the details in this watch. It's the use of Canopus white gold that brings a little bit of heft to the watch. It's the laser engraving of the hippocampus with the blue sapphire stone as the eye. And of course, the beautiful black onyx dial with the step. Although my wrists are fairly large, I think this 38.6 millimeter watch wears very nicely on the wrist, very comfortable. I also like the fact that it has no crown guards. It doesn't give me the feeling I'm wearing a vintage watch, like the Speedmaster from 2017, the 60th anniversary re-edition. But perhaps I also don't want to feel this to wear like a vintage wristwatch, but as a modern watch in white gold with the sapphire crystal and really as a piece of haute horlogerie. Omega let us know that they no longer do limited edition watches. So that also means that this is not a limited edition. Of course, it's limited by the fact that Caliber 321 is limited to a production capacity of around 2,000 pieces maximum. So only 2,000 Caliber 321 movements per year at maximum. And the majority of them will of course go to the stainless steel version introduced in 2020. And a few will go to the platinum version introduced in 2019. And there's of course a few necessary for this model. What caught me a little bit by surprise is the price tag of this Speedmaster Caliber 321 in Canopus Gold. It has a retail price of 75,000 Swiss francs or euros, including VAT. It makes it the most expensive Speedmaster in the current Speedmaster collection. The question I ask myself about this watch is that in the past and also today, the stainless steel Speedmaster Moonwatch was a very accessible luxury watch or luxury chronograph watch. This one isn't. So I'm wondering what this will do to the next best thing, which is the Speedmaster Broad Arrow from 2017 for the 60th anniversary. I'm curious what will happen to that one. What are your thoughts on this Speedmaster Caliber 321 in Canopus Gold? Would you spend 75k on a Speedmaster that is clearly haute horlogerie? Let us know in the comments. And for the 65th anniversary of the Speedmaster, we are very curious to see what else is coming this year. We will keep you posted. Thanks for watching. Make sure to subscribe and hit the like button.